Yeah, I don't need a code to do it though. So, I use Unreal Engine, and it's one of the easiest things to work with in the gaming industry right now. So that's what I use because it's so easy. But yeah, it's, I'm not gonna skip around, but it's a lot of fun. It's like, MSP?
There's gonna be a few more dropping.
Alright. Out here like fucking sloth.
Chocolate?
Ruth, baby?
How many of that?
23. Fucking chilling. All the rest are in bag room. It's in use. Yeah. What? Enjoying it. Trying to be courteous. He started shining the light in my face.
Sean, do you copy?
That's it.
Is it?
Yep. Okay, so I'm gonna run through some of the equipment that I have out here. I should say that we have out here. So I guess we'll start furthest back. So this is the air stairs. Typically you're only gonna be using this if the jet bridges aren't working, or if we have an aircraft over. Oh, that should be up. So this will be used if the jet bridges are not in use, or there's something wrong with them. And then if we have to hook up an aircraft down over there at the remote pads, or here in our alternate gate. And here's the lav cart. This is where all the shit flows through. We have a truck, so we don't use this anymore. Then over here, another parking brake got set. That's nice. So this is the air start, and these are, it's probably the most dangerous piece of equipment we have. Basically it forces air through one of these hoses here. And so basically you hook this up at the bottom of the aircraft. It's a big ass hose. You can kind of see some, I don't know if you can actually see that. Got some little flaps in there. As soon as you start sending air, plane basically sucks up that air, sends it through the engine and gives a little jump start when the APU is down, which normally will send air and redirect it down into the engine to get it started. You come on down this way. What we have over here is our ground power unit. This is probably the second most dangerous piece of equipment we have. Right now, I don't think this one's working. It has battery, but I don't think it's gonna work. So basically, when a jet bridge power is not working, we use this. And last few summers, we've been running these 24/7, so this thing's pretty broke. And the rest of our equipment that we have is down over across the taxiway over there. Can't really see it from here, but got some more equipment over there. And we got various pushbacks, four of them, in fact. Got number five, got the other one right there, and then you got Trapel. And then way across that way, I'll probably have to zoom in on it, you got Baby Push. And of course, two de-ice trucks over there. So that basically sums up all of the equipment that we have on hand. Oh, you can kind of see the air cart over there just hiding itself. We have two of those. And those ones are dangerous for a different reason. Those will, during the winter, when we're using them, you can actually fall and that thing will run over you. But yeah, it basically sums up all the equipment. All right, so next what we're gonna go over are the tow bars. So each aircraft has its own tow bar. So this one's for a 220, which will be for my gate over there here in a little while. And I already have a 220 tow bar on my gate, so we'll just take this one off for them. Yeah, so you have your Airbus tow bars, then your 737 tow bars. We'll go over here, since my gate's over here. Probably should stop messing with their stuff. I guess while we're passing them, here's your tail tip pulls. So this pull here is what keeps the 737-900s and above from tipping back. So here's your 737, 220, and then your Airbus 319s, the 321s. And then we have some 175, oh, here's the 175 one. So these ones are for that plane over there, which I should probably give them since I don't have any any Embraers today. I have, I think two Airbuses and then another 220, which actually my 220 isn't coming in first. Then there's another Embraer tow bar, the 175. So yeah, basically that covers all the tow bars, nothing really special about them. So yeah. Alright, so right now I'm going to get everything set up. We have a delayed flight that's coming in here in the next 20 minutes. So, gonna get everything set up down over there so we can utilize gate 16. And then we'll have another one coming into gate 22 shortly after. Now I'm gonna go down over here and grab myself the headsets and wands, and we all set to go for this delayed arrival. Go ahead and get this bad boy on here. Flight's on the ground, so we'll go ahead and get ready for this flight.
Delete that footage.
No. Alrighty, here she comes.
Tabitha, can you open the door?
Oh.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Looks like they tried marketing. Or unless it's a bell loader.
I mean, there is a mark next to it. It looks old.
Look at that.
Check to make sure they didn't load anything in here. does look like we have some stuff in here. Looks like it might be some kind of cargo, some ballast. We're about to find out though. Looks like cargo of some sort.